Hi there. In the early 1990s, I recorded some of the area between Garforth and Castleford using a Video 8 camcorder, following the route of the old railway line that had, for the most part, been dismantled in the late 1960s. Looking back at these now, nearly 30 years later, I thought they may be of interest to others, so I've retraced the route in 2021 to compare and see what changes have taken place. I've also included a few stills from the mid-1980s at Allerton Bywater that I'd taken at the time. Whilst reviewing these old tapes, I also came across some footage taken at Empsey near Skipton in the late 1990s of a locomotive called Primrose No. 2 that I now realise had worked at one of those collieries that the line had served, and I've included that here as well at the end. Just a quick word about health and safety. Looking back at these pictures from the early 1990s, it's clear that these were different times. The track bed was used as a walking route, and I even remember walking over the sleepers on a school-sponsored walk in the early 1980s. Walking on the working railway today is likely to be trespass, and more importantly, it's first and foremost dangerous. At the southern end of the line, it passes over the River Aire on a viaduct. That viaduct is now a dangerous structure, and it's heavily fenced off, and for good reason. I've put some links below so you can explore more about the line if you want to. I hope you find what follows interesting. Thanks for watching, and let's crack on. Just a quick potted history and overview of the line for some context. The Garforth to Castleford line was a single track railway line that was developed principally to allow coal to be transported from the area, although passenger service was operated between 1878 and 1951. Initially promoted by the Leeds, Castleford and Pontefract Junction Railway, it was taken over by the North Eastern Railway before construction was completed. The northern part of the line joins the main Leeds to York and Hull line immediately east of Garforth Railway Station. At its southern end, it joins the route of what was the York and North Midland Railway at Castleford East Junction. There were three intermediate stations: Kippax, although actually located at Great Preston; Bowers Halt, named after the hamlet it served, which in turn got its name from a colliery owner; and Ledston, actually located at Allerton Bywater and about a mile away from the village it was named after. The railway company already had a station called Allerton elsewhere on its network and chose the name Ledston to avoid any confusion. From a junction north of Bowers, a branch led west towards an open cast mine, which is now St Aiden's Nature Reserve, but back in the day served several collieries in the area. And from 1958, from the open cast itself, from the Bowers disposal point, where the tracks can still be seen in situ in the concrete roadway. There was also a mine at Garforth served by the line, Trench Pit, owned by the Gascoignes and named after a branch of the family. Trench Pit was quite short-lived, having been sunk in 1899 and closed in 1930. The site later became the home of Stocks Blocks, with one of the original colliery buildings, shown in the 1990s shots, surviving until it was demolished fairly recently to make way for a new housing estate. I'll shut up now and let the pictures and sounds speak for themselves. Thank you. It's something of a local legend that the Queen, accompanied by Prince Philip, actually slept on the royal train, which was stabled overnight on the line at Kippax, before it proceeded to cross gates on the following morning of the 22nd of October 1965, when she officially opened the new Seacroft Shopping Centre, which itself was demolished in 1999 and replaced by the current Tesco Extra and surrounding stores. One of the links below shows the station being prepared